I was a lot younger than I am now, which is 92, I am. And at the end of the service, the pastor said, before we go, we have something to do. And here came the elders of the church. We call them deacons in our church. And they said, we want to ordain you as a teacher. That's what they told me. I said, okay. And they ordained me as a teacher. And they gave me I've got a certificate at home where I'm ordained. And he called me to teach. That's what he called me to do. And I am not happy if I'm not teaching. I have to teach. I don't have an audience sometimes, but I find somebody to teach.
You teach me all the time. Every day. That's God. He told me to do it. He teach me all the time.
Isn't that amazing? I don't know how it happened, but there I was, a teenager in the church. I went to Sunday school all the time. We had Sunday school. I had a group of children before me, and they would say, we want you to give the special music today. Because I'd been practicing with them, and I'd been singing with them. And they would call us up, and the children would stand all here, in a group, and we would sing our songs, and the choir was behind us. We had a choir behind us, and I would have these children that I just adored. I knew them all. They loved me. I ministered the Lord to them all the time. And I would stand facing the choir, and they would be facing the congregation because everybody wants to see their child up there, you know.
Yeah. And I want to see my daughter.
I remember one time one of the people, the preacher or somebody, said this. Said, I wish you could see Doris's face when she leads the people. I said, it would bless you. But I was in it was beautiful to me. And I'm sure it did reflect on my face. I loved it. And I'm the same way about his word today. I spend hours studying his word. Don't I, David?
Yes, you do.
I've seen you do it too.
I love it. I love his word. I love teaching it. I'm supposed to teach it.